Hey guys, this is Uma from Syncfusion, and this video is all about the Syncfusion Angular Scheduler and its top 10 great features. If you guys already work with the scheduler component, then please post your comment below in which specific real-time scenario you most oftenly prefer to use the scheduler component. To define the Angular Scheduler, I can simply say it as a super good component that looks and works more similar to the Outlook or Google Calendar. Or to be more specific, I can say it as a tool that helps a person to plot and manage their daily activities. Say for example, you have an important meeting on this particular day between 9 and 10 a.m. and you want to make a note of it for your later tracking. At this time, you can create it as an appointment in the scheduler with relevant subject so that you can track and manage your time more easily whenever you need it. Not only such time management, but there are pretty much more features available on Angular Scheduler. In this video, I have chosen to prefer the top 10 among them. So before moving on to the feature list, let's have a look at the real-time applications that uses Scheduler. You can see the travel planner here, where the scheduler is being used to display the lowest airfare available for that month. This is one such real-time application, and in the same way, you can look on to our Angular Scheduler, where it's been designed as an airfare calendar showing the lowest available price on each day of a month. And another most widely used application is the doctor's appointment planner. So here you can see the scheduler being used for the purpose of managing the doctor's appointment, and you can see the list of appointments of all the doctors in a single calendar. If you choose any specific doctor, you can see the appointment of that particular doctor. You can also see some of the time being blocked, so which means that the doctor is not available on these particular time, and you can also see the unscheduled appointments. So you can add it to the scheduler simply by dragging and dropping onto the required time slots. So, and there are pretty much more to explore in this application, which will be available very soon in production. And like these examples, there are many more time scheduling applications where you can use our Angular Scheduler. And the last one such thing, I would like to clear the conception about the Angular version compatibility of Syncfusion Scheduler. Well, many of you have this question in your mind, whether the Syncfusion supports all Angular versions. Alright, you can find your answers here. We all knew that the new Angular versions are releasing more frequently. To deal with this progressive releases, our Syncfusion Angular UI libraries are constantly upgraded to make it more compatible with any of the newly arriving Angular versions. So you can use our Angular Scheduler in any of the latest Angular versions starting from 4. I hope you all are clear with the Angular version compatibility. So I'll go ahead by showing you examples now for every feature of Angular Scheduler, and also at the end of this video, I'll show you from where you can download the Syncfusion Angular Scheduler from. Alright, now let's move on to the feature list. The first and foremost is the appointments with recurring options. You can create and use any kind of appointments on Angular Scheduler. Here you can see the appointments that are created within the same day for a limited time interval, and you can also have another appointment to depict it for whole day, and this is termed as all day event. And when this particular appointment spans across multiple days, this is termed as spanned event. As you can see, this appointment has been created from 7th January to 9th January. And finally comes the recurring appointment, which repeats for the selected period of time. You can make it to repeat either a daily basis or weekly, monthly or yearly repeat patterns. The appointments plays a very basic and one of the most important role in the scheduler. And you can also easily interact with them through the drag and drop and resize actions. So you can resize it more easily, and you can also drag them across any of the time interval. The next important and mandatory feature is the appointment data binding. So how will you add or bind the appointment data to the Angular Scheduler? You won't believe how simply you could achieve this. You just need to bind the appointment data either as a local JSON data as depicted here with the relevant fields, subject, location, start time, end time, like that. Or else you can retrieve the data from a remote data source using the data manager as shown here. So here I will be passing the service URL through the data manager and then bind the appointments to the scheduler. So the remote data sources can be anything like RESTful services, OData or WCF services. So there are much simpler and flexible data binding options available on this Angular scheduler. Alright, now moving on to the next feature, I can strongly assure our Angular scheduler to be very responsive and touch friendly. As you can see, the scheduler in a desktop now with the more better view. The same way it has been designed to adapt well on the mobile and tablets as well. To see its responsiveness, let me show you by opening the mobile emulator in Chrome browser. So here you can see the scheduler that scales smoothly to fit into the available space. Now let's move on to the next interesting feature, scheduler views. Angular scheduler provides 10 different built-in views to display your appointments. The calendar-like views with day, week, workweek and month, and the same four views with timeline mode displaying the time in the horizontal orientation. Here you can see the timeline day, week, timeline workweek, month. Also, it has the agenda and month agenda views listing out the appointments in a list-like view structure. So here you can see the agenda view listing out the appointments on each day and the month agenda view displaying the calendar at the top space and its appointments at the bottom space. So from these available multiple views, you can choose the one that best fits onto your application. And the most interesting fact with this feature is, you can configure each individual scheduler view with different customization. For example, you can set different starting hour for the scheduler views. In week view, I have set it as 9 a.m. and in the day view has been set to start from 7 a.m. So there are much more customizations you can do on each view, which we'll see it on a later video. Alright, now let's look out for the most highlighted and usable feature of Angular Scheduler, the multiple resources and grouping. With this feature, a single scheduler can be shared by multiple resources, which means that each resource will have its individual calendar displayed within the same scheduler layout. Here you can see each resource having its own space for displaying its calendar. So in month view, you can see the layout displayed for each resources, and in timeline view, each row represents a resource and the events of those resources are displayed horizontally on each of the resource rows. If you would have noticed, the multiple resource grouping along with the timeline views plays a most important role in many of the real-time applications. The next appealing factor is the completely customizable UI of Angular Scheduler, which allows you to customize the appearance of any of its UI element. The built-in NG templates are available for customizing the scheduler elements like appointments, which you are seeing here. You can customize the cells as well as the date headers, and even you can customize the tooltips. And the most crucial customization that most of the users prefer in Angular Scheduler is the editor window customization. You all know that the default appointment window gets opened while double clicking the cells or appointments. Here you can replace the default window with the customized design using the editor template option. Even you can customize the quick pop-up that opens on single clicking the cells or events with the template option. Other than these core features, there are built-in 5 SASS-based themes that allows you to view the Angular Scheduler in different customized themes like Material, Fabric, Bootstrap, Bootstrap version 4 and High Contrast. So Bootstrap version 4, Bootstrap, Material, Fabric and High Contrast. You can also use the Theme Studio application for customizing the styles of Angular Scheduler on your own. So here, I'm simply changing the primary color to some other color. You can see the changes here. Let me change the primary font color from default white color to some dark gray, and I'm applying it now, so you can see the changes here. Alright, the next advanced features of Angular Scheduler are the exporting and importing options. These are the recently added new features that allows you to export the scheduler event data to iCal format or to the Excel format. And it also supports importing the appointment data from other calendars. For example, you can import your personal events from Google Calendar into this Angular Scheduler and vice versa. So let's see the example of Excel exporting. So I'm simply clicking the Excel export button, and you can see the Excel file with the appointment data exported from the scheduler. Let's see the export and import of ICS file here. So let me export this Angular Scheduler now with this appointment data. So now I open this file in Outlook. You can see the appointments, the same appointments of Angular Scheduler has been exported to Outlook calendar. In the same way, you can also import the appointments from other calendars. You can also import the same appointments, I mean, which you have exported now into this scheduler now. So I'm choosing the file which has been exported from scheduler now. And you can see the same appointments has been imported into the Angular scheduler. Alright, now moving on to the very basic but more powerful feature of using Syncfusion Angular Scheduler is it's completely built based on the lightweight and modular architecture. As I said earlier, the scheduler is comprised of many number of features. Therefore, these features are available as individual modules within the source repository. So you can reference only the needed features on your project, which in turn will reduce your application weightage. Here, you can see the feature modules of Angular Scheduler. So you need to inject any one of these modules whenever you want to use that particular feature on your application. And the next final feature is globalization, which is made much simplified with the Angular Scheduler, as it can be easily accessed by the global audiences in any of the languages with different culture settings. Also, it can display the current date and time by following the globalized date and time formats. So the list of top 10 features of Angular Scheduler comes to an end here. I'd like to know which specific scheduler feature you prefer or like the most to use it in your application. So please share your thoughts in the below comments section, and also mention if you want me to add any important features to this list. Now moving on to the link from where you can download the Angular Scheduler package. Syncfusion offers wide variety of platforms as well as the products. So navigate to the developer platform page, where you can see the essential JS2 products whose source code are purely written in TypeScript. In this tutorial, as we are proceeding with Angular platform, so I recommend you to choose the Angular option and expedite the features available in it. On scrolling down the page, you can see the various components available on the Angular platform, and you can also download the 30-day free trial by simply clicking on the download free trial button. You can also refer the scheduler package from GitHub source, or you can install it through the npm command since it is available in the npm js package. Let me share all these links at the end of this video. So finally, I'd like to end up this video saying that I tried to share the most important features of Syncfusion Angular Scheduler and also pointed out from where it can be downloaded from. So if you really enjoyed this video and felt of liking it, then give it a like and subscribe to our channel as well. Thank you so much for listening to this video. And in my next video tutorial, let's see how to create the Angular Scheduler in an Angular application with the very minimal configuration steps using the Angular CLI setup. Thank you.